Good evening. Thank you for being here. This is our spring jazz ensemble. We're going to just keep getting the guitars dialed in. You're going to hear all four of our curricular jazz ensembles tonight, including the last concert in this space with our Jazz Ensemble 1, which is bittersweet, of course. But we start tonight's concert with the Freshman Jazz Ensemble, and our first tune is called Blue Madness. Enjoy.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. You heard from Ken Callister on the trombone on that. You heard Justin Herderman on the guitar, Beckett Schoen on the tenor sax, and Mark Bauman on the trumpet. How about it for our soloists? So we have a member of freshman Jazz Ensemble 1 sitting in with us tonight on very late notice. So a big round of applause to Zen Mendoza, who got this music about 25 minutes ago. Thanks, buddy, for your help. We're going to move on with a tune called Los Changos Volando. You're going to hear Ken again on some soloing on trombone, and then you're going to hear from Evan McCarson on the tenor saxophone, along with kind of just a lot of like vibe kind of creating on from the rhythm section. Oh, you guys going to set up back there? Is that cool? There's room? Okay. And in a second, I'm going to thank Mr. Spencer, the one and only Mr. Isaiah Spencer back there. Our drum whisperer. We're so lucky to have amazing people working with our students. Mr. Spencer's a prime example of that. So please enjoy Los Changos Volando. Thank you.
Thank you. We're going to switch out pianists and guitarists one more time.
We have one more tune for you. This tune's called Short Stop. It's a shuffle. It has a strange form, which is tricky. 14 bars. Zen, did you hear that? 14 bars. Zen's getting a taste of like the real world right now. One time to look at the charts and then play the gig. And we've been working on improvising over this tune. What's cool about this tune is that it's a blues in F, right? But there's like a lot of twists and turns. So there's a lot of extra details in the harmony. So we're going to hear from Will Wheaton on trumpet, soloing on this tune, Juliana Capretta on the guitar, and Ian Sturgis on the piano. Enjoy Short Stop.
We continue now with Concert Jazz Ensemble. This is primarily our sophomore jazz band, but we do have a couple people joining us sitting in as well to just kind of thicken out our saxophone section. So we want to thank Isaac Cannell on tenor sax and Miriam Gorf-Beal on alto. And you'll hear more about this later from Mr. Meyer, but coincidentally, they're both going into music, so that's kind of cool. We're going to open our show tonight with La Suerte de los Tontos, which means Fortune of Fools, and was made famous by the Stan Kenton Orchestra on their album Cuban Fire. This is an example of Afro-Cuban jazz style. And we're going to hear from Jared Goldstein on tenor sax. Here's La Suerte de los Tontos.
Thank you.
One of the things that sort of defines the Afro-Cuban style is what we call polyrhythm, sort of that alternation of feeling like, hey, I'm in six, now I'm in three, one, two, three, four, five, six, da, 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 ya, da, 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 da. This next tune incorporates polyrhythm, but in a different way. This next one is, the time signature is 9/8, which means you got 9/8 notes. And typically the eighth notes, like if you're in a regular 9/8 time signature, they'd be grouped into triplets. Triplet, 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 triplet. But in this version, the composer groups it 2 + 2 + 2 + 3, which still adds up to 9. So you'll hear that in the melody. Check it out. Lots of polyrhythm. Good stuff. This is Blue Rondo a la Turk. We're going to feature Ari Varshney on trumpet and Danny Azinski on alto sax. Enjoy.
Thank you.
Every now and then we get to host student teachers from nearby universities. This fourth quarter we are hosting a student teacher from nearby Northeastern University. She actually completed her undergraduate in music and now is going back to get certified in teaching. So she brings a lot of experience and a little bit more maturity than your typical student teacher, which is awesome. Our students are definitely benefiting from her musicianship and leadership. Would you please welcome to the stage Miss Catherine Lucena.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Miss Lucena, and it's my absolute pleasure to be student teaching here at New Trier with Mr. Temple and Mr. Meyer. I'm only in my third week here, but the school and students have been incredibly welcoming, and it's a privilege to be able to get to work with them and be part of this presentation of their hard work this evening. Our final tune for you all is called Greetings and Salutations. It's a funky rock tune, and we'll be featuring several members of our ensemble. The intro will feature Danny and Jared on saxophone, and then our soloist this evening will be Skylar Weinstein on trumpet, Jared Goldstein on tenor saxophone, Ari Varshney on trumpet, Zach Azinski and Tyler Mills on trombone, Emiliano Gutierrez on guitar, Eli Chavla on bass, and Noah Shanker on the drum set. Thank you, and this is Greetings and Salutations.
Thank you.
We're just waiting for our bass player to do a quick wardrobe change. he was in the last band as well. This is Lab Jazz Ensemble. Many of these students traveled with us to New Orleans over spring break, which was a pretty awesome experience. And this first tune that we're going to perform for you is a tune called Alone Together. It's a really, it's a well-known standard. It's not an easy tune. And we were fortunate enough to be able to work with the arranger that wrote this particular version of Alone Together. He's a professor emeritus at Loyola University. We got to work with him at Loyola with a couple of the other Loyola faculty on Sunday, and then on the very next night we heard his band playing on the riverboat, which was quite a treat. In fact, a couple of us even sat in with his band on this tune. So please enjoy Alone Together. Thank you.
y'all notice the shrinking bass? That's no fair. Wasn't your fault, Eli. How about a hand for our sophisticated soloing on that tune? That's a serious tune. You hear it from Max, Klee, and Ben Newman, Theo Schoenberg, and Demir Fachko on that one. Thank you. Now we're going to play a tune by a really phenomenal young tenor saxophonist in New York named Lucas Pino. This is an original tune that he wrote for his nonet off of a record called, this is clever, the No Net Nonet. Thank you, Theo. this is called Where You Need to Be. You're going to hear Ben Newman soloing on this one and also Max Klee again. Are we good with the bass? Okay, cool. Enjoy Where You Need to Be.
Thank you. We have one more for you, but this is our spring jazz concert, and so by tradition, I'm going to say a little bit about each one of our seniors. Now, if you know our program, you know that we have a really large senior class this year, and so I'm going to go very briefly through our seniors. My brevity is no reflection of my affection for them, but more realization that I need to go quickly to get through all of them. But in this group, before we play our last tune, I want to introduce you to two seniors in lab jazz. First, Connor Mulvaney on alto saxophone here in the middle. Yes. Connor has been a dedicated member of our music program since the very beginning. I can picture Connor on a screen. I can picture where in his house he was zooming to us from in freshman jazz ensemble. Connor's an Eagle Scout, and he's planning to go to the Indiana University next year to major in finance. So congratulations to you, and thank you for everything you've contributed to our program. And on Barry saxophone, which is a new instrument he picked up this year, Matthew plays the clarinet in symphonic wind ensemble, and he's played the tenor saxophone in our jazz program until this year when I said, dude, we need a Barry sax. Would you play Barry sax in lab jazz? And he said, sure. Do you have one? And I said, yeah, we have one. And it's I think it's been a great fit for him. I think you match that instrument well. Matthew's also a dedicated rower. He's been on the rowing team for the last 4 years, and he is planning to study neuroscience. Is that correct? In college, and he's still deciding where that's going to be. But and I hope you continue to be musical. Congratulations to you. How about our seniors in lab jazz ensemble? All right, we're going to play one more for you. This one is called Philly Twist, composed by Kenny Dorham, but written, I think, is it fair to say that he wrote this for Philly Joe Jones? Okay. Good. I'm checking with their drummer back there. All three of these tunes that Lab Jazz is playing tonight were not written for students in any way, shape, or form, and including this tune that Kenny Dorham just wrote for his band on a record called The Whistle Stop. And so we're going to hear a number of blues solos. We're going to hear from Matthew. We're going to hear from Ben. We're going to hear from Theo. And is that it? Cool. And then, well, of course, drummer Theo saying, well, I'm soloing on this too. Of course he is, because it's a Philly Joe Jones too. We're going to hear some Theo Karasik on the drums. So please enjoy Philly Twist. And then stick around, because Jazz Ensemble 1 will be up next, and you definitely want to hear their set.
Thank you.
Thank you. This is Jazz Ensemble One, of course. That was Shiny Stockings, Frank Foster's brilliant, kind of unmatched swinger from the Count Basie Orchestra. You heard solos from Aryan Nakshinen. Yes? Oh. Peter Arlinson and Jared Famacion on that, as well as Peasy on the drums. So, this is a band full of seniors. In fact, everyone on the stage right now is a senior. Vincent Anderson's the only junior in this band. Demir is an honorary member of this band and for tonight, and he's not a senior. But everyone registered for the class, should we say that? Except for Vincent. So I'm going to start with the trumpets, and I'm going in alphabetical order, trumpets. So Billy, you're first. So I consider Billy to just be a big teddy bear back there in the trumpet section, right? He's one of the reasons the trumpet section was recently voted the cutest section in the band. But Billy tells me he's actually quite a savage beast on both the football field and the hockey rink. That sounds wrong. Ice? I don't know. Billy's on the football team and on the hockey team and on the jazz team. He's an incredibly sincere, fun, Billy brings the fun to rehearsal, but at just the right moment, then he also like steers us back into the sincere, like come on, let's actually be serious about what we're talking about. I've known Billy to love this music since like the very first days of Freshman Jazz Ensemble. And so, Billy, I'm super proud of you. What do my notes say? I think that's it. Can we give a big round of applause to Billy? Katie Hedberg is one of our lead trumpet players. She's the leader of the section. Katie, wave. I noticed Katie's intense focus and dedication very, very early on. I could see her taking notes in Freshman Jazz Ensemble. Like, she just wanted me to know that she would love this music. And I noticed it really quickly. And she hasn't really let up ever since. She's got incredible determination and clarity of purpose. And because of that, she's whipped this trumpet section into shape. Is that fair? Is that fair, trumpets? Uh-huh. She's serious. She means it. Katie's going to be going to the College Conservatory of Music at the University of Cincinnati next year to study trumpet performance and or jazz. How about jazz education? I think Katie would be an electric educator. She's a phenomenal trumpet player, and I hope the world gets to have you as a teacher. So thank you so much, Katie, for everything you do. Matthew Hepburn was sharing lead with Katie on that last tune. Matthew's also a very serious trumpet player. I kind of consider you kind of one of our secret weapons in the trumpet section, because we think of Katie as the lead, but then Matthew's always there, like, doing some of the heavy lifting right alongside her. Matthew's going to be going to Boston University next year, where he's hoping to play in, like, a non-major band or some sort of jazz ensemble while he's studying computer science. And Matthew tells me that one of the highlights for him of being in our jazz program was being able to stand shoulder to shoulder with Bijan Watson at Jazz Fest playing Soupbone. So, Matthew, thanks for all your contributions and congratulations to you. Next, alphabetically, is Aryan Nakshinen. Yeah? I really am trying. I'm sorry. here's the word I think of when I think of Aryan. Well, there's a lot of them, but Ruthie's terrified of what's going to come out of my mouth next. Now, Aryan, you're a rascal, right? He's a rascal, but he's also a really deep thinker. I remember Aryan's intense eagerness to make sure that I knew and the rest of the band knew that he was way into hip hop. This is freshman year, and especially like Jay-Z, he wanted to do like a book report on Jay-Z, like the fourth day of class, right? Am I right, Aryan? And ever since, Aryan and I have had sort of like this open dialogue about music and about what's happening. And he'll come to my office and say, "Mr. Mark, can I play you something?" And I'll close the door because sometimes it's not always appropriate for the hallway listening. But Aryan's like really deep into all sorts of music. And he's a really, really bright kid. I've really enjoyed like your openness to share your music and the things that you're really into with me. Arian's going to be going to Indiana University next year to study business and economics. Is that right? Just business. Okay. Yeah. I think I have a copy-paste problem here. Just business at the University of Indiana. Arian, we're going to miss you. Thanks for all your contributions. So finally, Ruthie, who's standing in the middle right now. Ruthie is notoriously friendly, maybe even chatty. Would we sometimes call her chatty? Ruthie has had an unfailingly great attitude since I first met her. You've made huge musical progress every year, and even this year, we've heard just constant growth from you. We're going to hear more of it tonight. It's really inspiring to see you constantly kind of commit yourself to growing as a musician. Ruthie's also been a softball player for like 8 years, four of them obviously here at New Trier, and she's going to Tufts University next year to major in biopsychology. So Ruthie, congratulations, and thank you for everything you contribute. All right, we're going to move on to some more music. We're going to play a tune called Little Karen, composed by Benny Golson and arranged by Quincy Jones. We got to play this tune at the very beginning of the school year when we played it at the Chicago Jazz Festival. And I thought it would be kind of fun to bring this tune back as a bookend to help close out our year. Span sounds amazing on this tune. You're going to hear from Duke Bauer on the tenor saxophone. Here we go. Little Karen. All right, now I'm going to move through the trombones and the saxophones. So Peter, that means you're up first. Peter Arlinson there playing lead trombone for us. An incredible musical arc, and just like when I think of the development of you musically and as a person over the last 4 years, I love it. I love your story over the last 4 years. I remember Peter in a pretty dark little corner somewhere at the beginning of his freshman year on Zoom, and I thought, man, if this kid shows up week two, I'll be surprised. I just wasn't sure, you know? And you know, you can imagine how terrified I was starting these young people on Zoom. These are the first students that I ever saw on a screen after I came back from our sabbatical and we were starting the fall of 2020. And I was just terrified that they were all gonna quit after the first week. I just didn't think it was gonna work. But Peter has made this unbelievable progress over the last 4 years. We've come to know him as a really, really significantly impressive lead trombonist and a soloist, but he's constantly checking out the music. He constantly has ideas for how to phrase things better. I think he always has ideas for me about which order the tunes should go in the concert. Like, the guy's got opinions, but they're informed, right? And they're rooted in your care of the music and the experience, and I'm super proud of you. And Peter's not sure where he's going to school next year, but he knows he's going to continue playing music. And he says one of his favorite moments was soloing over spring break. We got to work with Delphio Marcellus, and we were playing one of Delphio's tunes, and Peter got to solo on Mr. Marcellus's tune in front of him. And that was a pretty awesome moment. So, Peter, congratulations on everything you've accomplished. To Peter's right is Kyle Fox. Kyle wasn't in freshman jazz ensemble. Well, we roped him in, right? And you started sophomore year. And for as big as Kyle is physically, he was making just a tiny sound on the trombone. There was just this little sound coming out of the trombone, right? And man, has that changed in the last few years. It's really cool to see how you've really committed to becoming not only a wonderful euphonium player in Symphonic Wind Ensemble, but a really significant part of the sound of this band in Jazz One. Kyle is a rower. He's a pretty serious and committed rower. He was in Paris last summer rowing for the U.S. Junior National Team. And I believe you're going to continue rowing, is that right, next year, when he goes to school at Dartmouth to study bioengineering. Congratulations, Kyle. And over here with a fresh haircut is Augustus Nouriel. I know Augustus to be an unbelievably hardworking young man. I've seen him in the practice room, in the jazz room, just like fighting to get a line and not quitting until he gets it. And that has served you very well musically here at Nutrier, and I'm quite certain that that's going to continue to serve you really well for the rest of your life. I know how tenacious you are. So when challenges come up, I think if you just lean on some of the things you've learned here, you're going to be in good shape. Augustus has been on the Nutrier swimming and diving team for the last 4 years. He's not certain where he's going next year, but he'll go somewhere. You're just a really kind, thoughtful, caring kid, and I'm gonna miss you. So congratulations to you, Augustus. Okay, through the saxophone section, I'm gonna start down there with this young man. His name is Duke Bauer. I have never answered more questions from a student in my career, and I've loved every single one of them. Duke, you know, believes that all of my hours are office hours. right. And I've loved every minute of it. I discovered really early on that Duke just had a really active musical mind. He constantly had questions about a chord or what this sounded like or you name it, he was curious about it. And you can see where that curiosity can lead to. I have a saying with freshmen that curiosity does not reveal ignorance, it reveals questions do not reveal ignorance, they reveal curiosity. And I think you've been a good model of that. But speaking of being a good model, One of the things that I'm most proud of with Duke is how he has taken so many young players under his wing. He's led Jam Club this year and been a significant part of it last year. And I know that there are so many young students in our program that are excited about this music because of the model that you represent and sort of the shepherding of young players that you have done while you're here. So of all the impacts that you've had, Duke, that's one of the most notable in my book. Duke got into just about every music school that I've ever heard of. And he's pretty sure that he's going to be going to the Manhattan School of Music next year. He will contribute enormously to the New York jazz scene. So can we please give Duke a huge round of applause? So to Duke's left is Kanoa Ween. Kanoa is a serious saxophonist in his own right, and I give him a lot of props for playing one of the hardest books in the band, second alto. None of those parts make sense, and he's got to play in this saxophone section, playing all those second alto parts. Kanoa is going to go to the Denison University or UW-Madison or University of Illinois Urbana-Champaign, one of those. He's a busy guy. He coaches lacrosse, he teaches sailing, and he teaches Hebrew at his Hebrew school. I know Kanoa for sort of like your unique mix of no-nonsense, like let's get this done kind of demeanor, but then he'll come in with like a zinger, you know? He'll have like, you'll think he's just all serious, and then all of a sudden he'll like kind of break the ice with his humor. But Kanoa, you've done an amazing job this year hanging in the saxophone section. And we're thankful for all your contributions. Congratulations. Our lead alto saxophonist is Miriam Goreff-Behel, a quite highly decorated young jazz musician at this point in their career. What do I say, Miriam? So two or three summers ago, you were at Birch Creek, right? And missing changes all over the place. Right? But the faculty sitting in the back of the barn listening to Miriam play were kind of all like, yeah, but they're on a journey. Like, we can hear the exploring that you were doing. Even back then when you were missing changes and weren't sure where you were in the form, we were all looking at each other like, yeah, but there's something there for sure. We could hear it in your sound, in your courageousness, and all that has just kind of turned into this unbelievable young musician who's on this stage, not only leading the saxophone section, but playing some brilliant solos that you've heard throughout the year and are going to hear some more of tonight. Miriam, it's been a thrill to watch you kind of grow into yourself as a saxophonist, and we all have a lot more kind of absorbing to do. Miriam is planning on going to the Juilliard School next year to study jazz saxophone. Congratulations, Miriam. One of Miriam's very good buddies is to their left. This is Isaac Hannell, and I got his name right, right? Another really serious saxophonist in this very serious section. Second tenor is also a very hard book to play. None of those parts make sense, and he makes it sound easy. He has a voracious appetite, as you can clearly see. That's what he said. That's what he told me. And he's also a rock climber, which I didn't know. Isaac's planning on going to the University of Maryland to study many things: philosophy, political science, economics, and jazz studies. There's a career in there somewhere, I think, right? Yeah. Yeah, one of those things will pan out, or maybe a combination of all of them, right? Isaac also plays clarinet in our symphonic wind ensemble. He's a double threat. Congratulations, Isaac. This is Michael Siraki. Michael's an incredibly driven and determined young man, right? He's very into fitness. He's determined to never be on time to class, and he's accomplished that, right? You've worked really hard at that. He's an enigma because we love to joke about Michael because he's a very fun-loving kid, but he's also in the Army Reserves, and he takes his goals very seriously. Another one of his goals is to be an orthopedic surgeon. And I'm quite certain that you're going to accomplish that because I know how kind of dogged you are about pursuing your goals. It's pretty cool to watch. Let's see. Yep. the last thing I'll say about Michael is that on the trip, I think Michael discovered, maybe was in the process of discovering, how awesome it is to just be in this group of amazing people that all love each other and take care of each other. And so today and yesterday and even this week, Michael's been talking about like just like how bonded the saxophone section is and how bonded the whole band is and how that the caring for each other translates into the way that they make music with each other. And that's been really cool to hear you articulate and to, for all of us to be able to hear. So congratulations to Michael and everything he's accomplishing. Should we play a tune? Okay, we're gonna play a tune for you that you've probably heard of. It's called Summertime. Maybe you haven't heard this version before. You're gonna hear solos from Miriam and Isaac and Arian on this, yeah? All right, enjoy Summertime. Thank you. All right, before we play our last tune, I'm going to acknowledge the rhythm section. So, Jamie, stay right there, actually. So, about to walk off the stage, but not, is Jamie Koplow, one of our guitarists, and like an unbelievably steady presence in the band, including on that last tune. Jamie's job often is to play rhythm guitar and just provide the quarter note throughout the entire tune. And you've become a really sophisticated rhythm guitarist in that way, Jamie. It's been very cool to see you develop that way. Jamie is planning to study electrical engineering next year. Still deciding between schools, but one of the secrets that Jamie was keeping from me for a long time was that he's a math whiz. And students started kind of revealing that to me over the course of the last year. So it makes sense that he'll be studying electrical engineering next year. Let's give Jamie a huge round of applause. Congratulate him. Sitting at the piano right now is Jared Formacion. Maybe the most gentle soul in the band. Is that, don't you think, guys?
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah? I mean, tied with Billy, probably. I know Jared to be an incredibly thoughtful and reflective young man. He loves to listen intensely. You can just tell that when something's happening, whether it's musical or a conversation, he's like really engaged. I think you really kind of enjoy the process of watching us make decisions and sculpt music. And I know that he's really close friends with a lot of the guys in the rhythm section because they're bonded in that journey. Jared is going to be studying English next year and creative writing. And Jared wants to get into this idea of teaching people to be teaching creativity and imaginative thinking, which I think is very awesome. So, Jared, thank you for everything you've contributed to our ensemble for the last couple of years. Congratulations. And sitting at the keyboard is Tyson Eng. Tyson is the very first student who logged on freshman year. I will never forget it. I wasn't sure anyone was going to show up, and then Tyson's face popped up, and I thought, oh, thank God. At least there's one. And Tyson has stuck around, obviously. And I was so glad to see you then. And I'm so proud of you for making it through this journey and being here, being with us tonight. Tyson is deciding between Penn State, Michigan State, University of Iowa, and UIC. And he's planning to study biology next year. Tyson, congratulations. Mason McCarthy on the bass is another one of our Eagle Scouts. Mason told me that opening for Delphio Marcellus at Snug Harbor while we were on spring break was one of the highlights of his time in the music department here at New Trier. I'm happy to hear that. Mason's been another one of those like super reliable members of our rhythm section. It's been a real joy to watch you develop and grow through our music program, Mason. And you're going to my hometown, Milwaukee, for school next year. Mason is going to be studying health science in the Honors College at Marquette University. Congratulations to you. Standing behind the piano there is Zen Mendoza. No one in the band has a name more fitting. Zen is an incredibly chill, still waters run deep kind of guy. Isn't that true? Yeah? All right. Unless like there's this completely other side to Zen that I haven't seen yet. But my sense is that he's just super chill all the time. But man, is he a good spirit. He's soulful. And he's loved by everybody in the band. Mason and Zen were both total champs over spring break, carrying this bass, this rented bass that we had all over the French Quarter in this janky case. They did such a great job. The other day, both Mason and Zen were not in rehearsal, and we were like sort of dysfunctional as a band. It's amazing how you just can't do this without reliable bass players, and these guys have been amazing. Zen, we know that you're continuing, you're planning to keep music very close in your life next year moving forward, and we're looking forward to what you're going to do with that. Can we give a big round of applause to Zen? And finally, Poira Zatesh on the drums. You know, as I was writing my script, like the number of times that I wanted to say, like, this kid's the heart and the soul of the band. And then I thought, well, you can't write that about one kid. And then I thought, like, but kind of I want to say that about all of you. Like, there's, we're not a band because one of you decided to step up and lead. We were a band because all of your personalities came together and you decided that you wanted to do this together, right? But nobody kind of plays with more joy and just more pure, like, in the moment than Poira's. It's been amazing to watch him grow and to become, like, really serious about his musical career. Not only is he a great drummer, he's an amazing pianist and songwriter. I know you play other instruments as well. I've seen you dabble. He also knows how to put, you know, kind of ambitious projects together. Last year, he put together a big band of his peers to play a benefit concert for the earthquake victims in Turkey. They raised more than $11,000. And I think that's just the beginning of what you see as possible in music and in kind of organizing and inspiring people. I can speak from experience. It's not easy to put a band together and to run it. It's amazing what you've done, Poira. And he's going to the San Francisco Conservatory of Music, and they have an amazing program out there called The Roots in American Music, and he's going to be a drummer in that program, which I think is very, very cool, and I think fits you and fits them well. So congratulations on all of your success. Those are our seniors. Thank you for hanging with us as we give each one of these remarkable young people a little moment. We're going to close the program tonight with a piece that hopefully you know. This is called Lift Every Voice and Sing. And we're going to hear from Vincent Anderson as he kind of carries this tune for us. Please enjoy Lift Every Voice and Sing. I hope you notice in your program that we are going to be playing at Space in Evanston in a couple of weeks in May. I hope you'll consider joining us there. We're going to play kind of like a hybrid set. We're going to play tunes, some of these tunes again, some other tunes. So please come and join us with the Evanston Township High School Jazz Band. It's going to be a very cool night of music. May 14th, I think, at Space in Evanston. And thank you for all of your support throughout the year. What we're able to do as a jazz program is because of incredible support from family and friends. And I'm grateful to be able to stand in front of these young people and watch them make this music. And I'm grateful for your support. So thank you. Enjoy Lift Every Voice and Sing. Thank you so much. Thank you for your support. Hopefully we'll see you at Space and at our combo concert. Enjoy.